Hey guys, it's me, Drew, and welcome to Empties number 8. This is my 8th Empties video that I have made, and just like every Empties, it is packed to the brim, ready to tell you all the things that I finished up. We are going to start this off with a shower gel. This is the 1000 Wishes shower gel from Bath & Body Works. I have mentioned this in my Bath & Body Works Christmas haul that I was using this shower gel and it absolutely stunk. Well, it did not change. It still stunk. It smelled like Robitussin. My sister actually finished this one up as a bubble bath. So, not that good. I finished up a mango shower gel from The Body Shop. Now, this is yummy. I love The Body Shop's mango scent. It's extremely sweet, but it has this really crispness to it that I really like. So, I finished that up. And all the Body Shop shower gels are soap-free, which is pretty cool that you get clean without soap. This is the Ponch shower gel from Lush, and I wouldn't have planned on finishing this up, but I did because it expires on December 31st. And this says, This tequila and orange juice gel packs a serious punch. Inspired by a traditional Mexican Christmas punch, Ponch is citrusy, boozy, and uplifting. The only thing I don't like about Lush shower gels, I love the way that they foam up. I hate the thinness, even though that's nothing really important, but they're really thin, so they're extremely watery. But I finished this one. I finished up another 32-ounce from Philosophy in Fresh Cream. Fresh Cream is my absolute favorite scent. I love it so much, so I finished this one up, and it's just sweet and everything, and the Philosophy shower gels are incredible. I finished a couple Body Shop shower gels. I finished a Vineyard Peach, which smells literally just like a peach. It's extremely sweet, but it has the fuzz of a peach scent to it. It's really yummy. I finished Satsuma, and Satsuma is bright, citrusy, super, super, super uplifting. It's great to use in the early morning. Also, I do want to make a point that I do not start and finish these products in the length of time. Like, for example, this olive shower gel was down to here when I picked it up again to use it. I do not use the same shower gel or anything every day, so it takes a while for me to use these up. Like, if you look through, this haul was probably from over a year ago, so I mean, this little shower gel takes me forever to use up. This is the Olive shower gel, which is one of my favorite scents from The Body Shop. It's extremely fresh and clean, and especially in the body scrub, it's really, really earthy, which I really like, so that's the shower gel. Oh, I finished a creme brulee 24-ounce shower gel from Philosophy. It looks like that. And this smells just like creme brulee. Like, you even get the burnt sugar and everything. It's awesome. I love creme brulee. I finished, from Philosophy, one of the hot salt body scrubs. This is a 23-ounce in candied pecan. This smells just like those nuts that you get at the mall that are really coated in cinnamon and sugar, and this scrub was extremely thick. You actually had to, like, pinch it out of the container, and it was super, super, super grainy. So when you used it, it was super rough on the skin. It was so nice. I loved it. Don't want to talk about deodorant that much, but I finished another one of my favorite deodorants. This is the La Vanilla Healthy Deodorant, and this is the one in Vanilla Passion Fruit, and it smells really, really good. It works really well. I like it. I finished both a Pure Grace and an Amazing Grace hand wash from Philosophy. These hand washes are pretty awesome. They're really, really, really gentle on the skin. I actually have them. I had them sitting in a caddy next to each other, so I had the choice of which one I wanted to use on different days. Same with the Amazing Grace. I finished the Jumbo Supersize 16-ounce Whipped Body Cream in Amazing Grace. And the Whipped Body Cream is such a great texture. It melts right into the skin. You don't ever have to worry about your skin feeling greasy or anything. And, like, if I take a shower in the morning, put this on, this would be the only fragrance that I can wear for the day. I don't have to layer on the perfume or anything to be scented all day, which I think is absolutely incredible. I finished, the label fell off, but this is one of my, number one Number one amazing hand cream brands, L'Occitane 25% or 20% shea butter hand cream. Love it. Love it. Love it. L'Occitane 10% shea butter vanilla bouquet ultra soft cream. This is one that was in that Today Special Value, but this is the one that I had before. This cream is awesome for your body. It also is very highly scented. And the thing is, you can actually, I'm going to pop the insert out and save the container. So I'm actually going to save this container. I didn't even realize I didn't take this top part out either. But yeah, see? So they just pop right out. And then you have a nice little container. I don't know, put push pins or something. Something in it. I don't know. Doesn't smell like anything because it was gone. But see, these lids are super hard to get on right away. So I finished that. It's a great product. I finished a Dancing Waters Gentle Foaming Hand Soap from Bath & Body Works. This was actually at my dad's house. My dad uses this. It's very fresh and clean. I finished a Satsuma bar soap from The Body Shop as well. I keep a bar soap in the bathtub. Not in the bathtub, but in the bathroom. So whenever I take a bath, I like to use a bar soap. I finished a body scrub from the Bathing Garden, Winter Palace, Third Wrap. I don't even want to tell you. I finished a couple Tarts. This is now Him Fragrance. I finished a Party Light melt in Mango Tangerine. This was super yummy. I actually have it currently in my warmer right now. It's very, very, very tart, but I like it. I finished the Perfect Pet in the Fresh Home line. This is nice on like a Sunday when I'm cleaning the house and I just want to... Why is this not focusing? And I just want to have, you know, a perfect scent that's fresh and clean. And this kills pet odors too. So it was nice and fresh and clean. I finished from Pink Zebra the Just Peachy Sparkles. This was okay. It was nothing grand. I don't really like Pink Zebra, but it was okay. I still have like a couple sprinkles left, but I finished from the Light the Night Candle Company Lemon Pound Cake, and I noticed these candles do get very, very, very sooty. Look at that. Very sooty. But it was a nice burn, pretty strong scent. Oh. A couple more tarts. I have Honey Bunny Tarts from Tiffany Candles. This smells just like honey. I wash the kids' soap, as well as It's Raining Men Shower Gel from Lush. I finished a Front Porch Grubby Tart in Smoochin' by the Fire. This was okay. I would not repurchase it. It was almost too woodsy for me. I finished... Oh, there's two more beauty items. I forgot that I stuck these in the back. I finished the 15% Shea Butter Foot Cream from L'Occitane, a travel size that I kept on my bed. It's amazing, purifying foot cream. And then I also finished a Josie Maran Argan Sugar Balm Body Scrub in Moroccan Escape, which smells just like sweet tarts. This is the best body scrub I've ever used in my life. This and the Olive Oil Body Scrub from Philosophy. If I only had a choice between those two the rest of my life, I'd be fine. It leaves your skin so soft. Now... Let me make sure. Yep. Now onto candles. I finished a 3-layer candle from Bath & Body Works in We Love Fall, which was Sweet Cinnamon Pumpkin, Sweater Weather, and Pumpkin Apple. This was okay. I'm not a fan of Bath & Body Works candles anymore. They're not really that strong, and this one wasn't either. I finished a Cheers to Capri Limoncello candle. This was okay. It burned all the way down, like all the way down to the metal. This was a nice scent. I like the limoncello scent. I finished Tailgate. This candle was strong. It smells like a football. Like a football and moss. Like it was a weird scent, but it was super strong. I finished Applewood Bonfire, which I really like. I love their fireside scent, but they never really have it anymore. And this has that same scent with a little bit of a sweet applewood scent, which really makes it awesome. The last Bath & Body Works candle I finished up was Frosted Cranberry, and this I love, too. This actually burned really clean, besides the soot, it cleaned really well. This is super yummy. I mean, it has the cranberry note, it has all the great peach, raspberry, just the great scents for Bath & Body Works. And last but not least, of course, I finished my Gold Canyon Banana Nut Bread candle. This burned super clean all the way down, as you can see. No soot all the way down. Amazing strong fragrance. Knock you out strong. Love these candles to death. If you would like to order them, there it is right there to reorder. But that was my empties number 8. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. And I'm sure I'll talk to you before that. But if not, have a wonderful Christmas and a happy new year. See ya!